गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी मैंगर, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज कोटा. द टॉपिक दैट वी विल डिस्कस टुडे इज लाइफ साइकिल एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ फैसियोला हिपैटिका. Life cycle of Fasciola hepatica is complex and completed in two hosts. Primary host is the one in which the adult fluke lives, that is the sheep, while the intermediate host is in which numerous larval stages are passed is a snail, limnia or planorbis. This type of life cycle involving two different kinds of hosts is termed digenetic. Self-fertilization is of rare occurrence in liver flukes, though they are hermaphrodite. Cross-fertilization preceded by copulation is of normal occurrence. In Fasciola hepatica, copulation takes place in bile ducts of the host. Two flukes in copulation bring their genital pores in opposition. Serous of one fluke everted through its gonopore penetrates the Lorer's canal of the other through the latter's temporary opening and injects spermatozoa. Secretion of prostate glands and perhaps also of the Mehle's gland keep the sperm active for fertilization. Fertilization is internal. In cross-fertilization, sperms received in Lorer's canal during copulation enter the distal end of oviduct where fertilization occurs. During self-fertilization, sperms enter the uterus of same fluke through female genital aperture and pass down to fertilize the eggs. Each fertilized egg or zygote is surrounded by yolk cells, which provide yolk and shell mineral. Shell globules of yolk cells contain proteins and a phenol. According to Stephenson, phenol is oxidized to a quinone in the proximal part of uterus. Quinone then tans the protein, producing a hard, resistant and leathery sclerotin, like that of insects. This sclerotin forms the shell around fertilized eggs. Above finding of Stephenson in liver flukes is perhaps true for all platyhelminthes. Shelled eggs are termed capsules or simply eggs. A shell or capsule is yellow or brown in color and oval in shape. It is about 130 to 150 mu long and 60 to 90 microns wide. It is operculate, that is provided with a lid or operculum. Situated immediately beneath the operculum at the terminal end of egg is a viscous and granular cushion. About 3000 or more such capsules may occur at a time in the uterus of a single fluke. There may be as many as 200 flukes in the liver of one sheep. If each fluke produces 5 lakh eggs in 10 years, a single infected sheep may disperse 100 million fertilized eggs. This vast capacity for egg production is necessary in view of the complicated life cycle of and slim chances of survival. Cleavage and embryonic development. Cleavage starts while eggs are still in uterus. Cleavage is holoblastic and unequal. First division of zygote results in two unequal cells, a larger somatic cell and a smaller propagatory cell. Subsequent divisions of somatic cell form larval ectoderm and tissues. Propagatory cell divides further into two daughter cells. One daughter cell by its division finally produces the larval body. Other daughter cells divide several times to form a mass of smaller germ cells, which cluster in the posterior part of larval body. encapsulated embryos or capsules or simply eggs do not develop further in Fluke's uterus. A very large number of capsules leave Fluke's body through its gonopore into host's intestine and finally ejected out with its feces. Further development takes place when capsules come in contact with water, which is slightly acidic. Optimum temperature for development ranges from 22 degrees centigrade to 25 degrees centigrade. The first larval stage involved in the life cycle is Miracidium larva. When suitable conditions become available, the encapsulated embryo in 4 to 15 days differentiates into a Miracidium larva. It hatches out and swims in water. Hatching is initiated by a proteolytic hatching enzyme. It dissolves the cementing material by which operculum is attached, thus releasing the operculum. Miracidium is a minute structure about 0.07 mm long, oval, elongate and richly ciliated active creature. Its broader anterior end is produced into a mobile and non-ciliated apical papilla or teribratorium. Miracidium is a multicellular organism. Its body is covered with flattened ciliated epidermal plates or cells, 21 in number, and arranged in 5 rows or tiers. Number and arrangement of cells in each tier is fixed. First tier has 6 plates, 2 dorsal, 2 lateral and 2 ventral. Second tier also has 6 plates, 3 dorsal and 3 ventral. Third tier has 3 plates, 1 dorsal and 2 ventrolateral. Fourth tier has 4 plates, 2 right and 2 left. Fifth tier has 2 plates, 1 left and 1 right. Beneath epidermal plates is a fine layer of subepidermal musculature, consisting of outer circular and inner longitudinal fibers. Below muscles is a layer of cells forming the subepithelium. Epidermal plates, subepidermal musculature and subepithelium together form the body wall of Miracidium. Within the body of Miracidium are present glands, nervous tissue, protonephridia and germ cells. A sac-like multinucleate mass of granular protoplasm is attached to the center of apical papilla by a stalk. This structure, earlier thought to be rudimentary gut, is now regarded as apical gland. A pair of large unicellular cephalic or penetration glands open by their narrow end near the apical papilla. A large brain with several associated nerve fibers lies dorsally below epidermal cells of second tier. Situated above the brain is an X-shaped larval eye, consisting of 2 crescentic pigmented cells or eye spots. With their concavities facing away from each other, the concavities contain a clear refractile material serving as lens. A photoreceptor of any sort is absent in adult due to its parasitic mode of life. A pair of long tubular protonephridia or flame cells open to the exterior through 2 nephridiophores or excretory pores, situated laterally in the posterior half of the body. Germ cells lie in groups, called germ balls, in the rear part of body. Miracidium does not feed. It swims about desperately as if seeking something with feverish haste. Miracidia try to penetrate any object or organism they may come across. But only those succeed that come in contact with a specific intermediate snail host. Those which do not come across the suitable host in about 24 hours after hatching die invariably. For penetration, Miracidium attaches its apical papilla and performs boring movements together with contractions and expansions of body. This process, aided by the action of flesh-dissolving larval secretions, results in a minute opening in the host's tissue. The larva then squeeze through this opening, casting off its ciliated epidermis. While doing so, it soon makes its way into the digestive gland of snail, where it undergoes various changes and in about 14 days develops into the second larval stage, the sporocyst larva. The sporocyst looks like an elongated sac about 0.7 mm long. Its body wall retains all the layers of body wall of Miracidium except the ciliated epidermis, which is lost in the process of penetration and soon replaced by a thin cuticle. Glands, brain, eye spots and apical papilla of Miracidium degenerate and disappear in sporocyst. Protonephridium of each divides into two flame cells, which open outside by a common excretory pore. In addition, the sporocyst contains germ balls. Sporocysts move about in the tissue of host, absorbing nutrition from it. Its germ balls develop into the next larval generation, the ridia. Each sporocyst produces 5 to 8 ridia. Ridia emerge from the sporocyst by rupture of its body wall. Each ridia is an elongated and cylindrical creature, about 1.3 mm to 1.6 mm long. It bears a mouth at the anterior end, a ring of muscular swelling or collar near anterior end, a permanent birth pore a little behind the collar, and a pair of projections called lappets ventrolaterally near the posterior end. Body wall consists of the usual layers, cuticle, musculature of outer circular and inner longitudinal fibers, and subepithelium. Mouth leads into a short muscular pharynx followed by an elongated sac-like intestine, which is lined by single layer of cells. Numerous unicellular pharyngeal glands open into pharynx. Protonephridia divide further and form a much branched system. All the flame cells of each side open out through a common excretory duct. Body of larva is packed with germ balls and mesenchyme cells. Ridia moves through the host's tissue on which it also feeds. Movements are brought about by muscular contractions of body, aided by the collar and lappets. Moving ridia enter various organs of snail, but prefer to migrate to its digestive gland. During summer months, when sufficient nourishment is available, the germ balls of ridia give rise to a second generation of ridia, morphologically identical to the parents. During winters, germ balls of ridia of second generation develop into larvae of the next stage, known as Cercaria larva. Each ridia produces 14 to 20 Cercaria larvae. They leave the body of ridia through its birth pore and enter the snail's digestive gland. Morphologically, Cercaria bear a close resemblance with the adult fluke. It has an oval body with a long simple tail for swimming. Layers of its body wall are the same as of sporocyst and ridia. Cuticle bears backwardly directed spines. Mature Cercaria make its way through the host tissue into its pulmonary sac and from there escape to the surrounding water. It takes about 35 to 65 days after entry of Miracidium into the body of the snail to the exit of Cercaria from the host body. As many as 1,000 metacercaria may be found attached to a single grass blade. They have a rounded form with a diameter of about 0.2 mm. Metacercaria is in fact the juvenile fluke, also called Marita. It differs from Cercaria in that it has a rounded form, a thick hard cyst, and large number of frame cells. It lacks a tail and cytogenous gland cells, and its excretory bladder opens out directly through a single pore. Germ cells or the genital rudiments are present as such. Cyst provides protection against short periods of desiccation. Metasarcaria develop into adult fluke only inside its definitive host or sheath. The latter gets infection by grazing on leaves and grass blades to which the cysts are attached. Metasarcaria survives action of host's gastric juice as its cyst is insoluble in it. Cyst wall finally dissolves in proximal part of intestine and liberates the larva. It penetrates the intestinal wall and gets into coelomic cavity, where it infects the liver, feeds on its tissue, and grows in size in 5 to 6 weeks. It then takes up its position in the bile duct, where it finally attains sexual maturity. In 11 to 13 weeks after entering the body of host, it starts laying eggs. This diagram is showing the life cycle of Fasciola hepatica. Thank you.